Whoop-diddy-scoop. That's what it feels like. It all feels like that.
Oh, hello. Good morning from New York City on a Sunday. What's up? What's good? How are you? I know what you're thinking. Come on, Bear. I know what you're thinking. Why weigh in on this right now? Well, I'm weighing in right now just for 5 minutes because I'm noticing now that all of the videos are coming out. I guess maybe they were told to wait a day or something because now everyone's releasing their videos of their trip, their big trip to Wyoming. So I have to just spend a minute because it seems like if I don't, I end up being misconstrued on Twitter with just like writing. So let me make it very clear. Let me explain. I do not expect, nor would I want anyone, why is my head so bright? That's what bothers me. I would not expect or want anyone to not love Kanye's music. See what someone just said? It's not that big a deal, for real. It's not that big a deal. That's the plan, for you to think nothing's a big deal, right? For you to think the things that are being said in the culture we live in right now are not a big deal. Oh, maybe you think what Roseanne said's not that big a deal. Maybe you think white supremacy's not that big a deal. All of it's not that big a deal, right? And apparently it's not that big a deal because people were upset and then they got an invitation to go to Wyoming. Oh my God, on a private jet. And do you know how smart Kanye and company are? They did it for like every small market radio station that never gets a chance to go to stuff like that. So everyone got to go. And no, I'm not falling for Kanye's trap because I'm not playing his music. I'm not supporting it. I got my radio show tonight. I will not be playing one Kanye West song. Now, I'm not saying I'm never going to play Kanye again, but I liken it to someone who's in a marriage. You know, we have a long relationship with Kanye West. Obviously, I'm not throwing him out from my life. He's a great artist who I've loved and supported for years. But if you're married to someone and someone in the relationship goes and does something terrible, you may not want to divorce that person, but that doesn't mean you want to go to fucking Wyoming to celebrate them right now. The man never explained anything. In fact, he's not explaining. What he's doing now is setting up a narrative to blame the whole thing on mental health issues. It's even worse. It's even worse. And by the way, Kanye's drug that he's talked about being on, Lexapro. Lexapro is an anti-anxiety medicine, okay? It is not about multiple personality disorder or any of the stuff that's being said now. So that narrative has changed in order to excuse and make everything some sort of experiment. So real quick, I'm not saying you're a bad person if you went to Wyoming. I get it. It was exciting. One of the greatest artists of all time asked if you wanted to take a free trip to Wyoming. So you did it. But understand here, this is, guys, I've seen Chris Rock at a party before, seen Kim Kardashian. I've been out. I'm not gonna just get excited and geared up and run to Wyoming because you felt like having a party and now everybody forgets. And now everybody gets their exclusive interviews, which is him wearing the exact same outfit. It's basically the same of someone saying, you're gonna interview LeBron James after a basketball game and you get all excited and run to the game and your interview's a big scrum with everyone sitting in one room holding up a microphone. And by the way, you're so hurt. I was invited. Do you want me to, I'm not gonna be a Kanye and post the text messages. I was invited. You think they invited every DJ from Middle America and didn't invite me? I was invited and didn't go. It's called having some moral code and some backbone whatsoever because this was offensive. All this stuff that happened, the entire Kanye's, you realize he upped the approval rating of the president in Black America by 10%. He literally made an impact. You think he's not making an impact? Wait, do you not think that Harvey Levin's in bed with Donald Trump? And do you not think that Kanye's in bed with Harvey Levin? Y'all are such sheep. You Kanye fans are such sheep. It's so pathetic. Get a life. He doesn't care about you. He's just an artist. And frankly, he's an artist who's rarely stood for anything. Okay? I love his music, but he doesn't stand for anything. He never really has. Go find yourself an artist, dude. There are artists out there who really stand for something. There always have been. Go listen to a KRS-One album. Go listen to Kendrick Lamar. Go listen to Chance the Rapper. You losers. You're losers. You people who can't stop saying, don't hate on him. Do you have anything in your head? You just follow what this man says? Because he's an incredible talent? Do you want me to point out incredible talents who don't stand for anything? That's right, there's a new Black Thought album. There's an ASAP Rocky album. There's a Pusha T album. I know Kanye was involved in that, but whatever. That's Pusha's friend. I'll give Pusha a pass. That's his friend. That's who he works with. But for all of you people who aren't friends, and you just sit here pathetically holding on and think that I'm a bad person because I've actually held on to my morals? Like, are you serious? Kanye is one of my all-time favorite artists. Oh, well, I'll love his music again one day. I love My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. I love Graduation. These are classics. I paid money for his concerts. I am a fan, but I am not a friend. And so I'm not obligated to do any of this stuff. And a lot of you so-called journalists were upset, but the second you got an invitation, you ran out, and now you forgot about it. You're just analyzing the music. It was all just part of his marketing scheme. I'm not playing the music. And if you're dumb enough to think that, I just saw a message there. Kanye is right. Kanye doesn't even know what he was saying, moron. He doesn't know. He didn't even understand. Everyone who's close with him said when they talked to him, he didn't have a connection between his brain and his mouth. It wasn't making sense. It wasn't making sense. Putting on the MAGA hat didn't do anything. Helping blow up Candace Owens, who's a mouthpiece for the right, that's not doing anything. That's not doing anything positive. Are y'all that dumb? Do you understand it? There are people out there who use hip-hop culture and then turn around and are racist. And Kanye West just justified those people. And all these people got so geeked. I'm from New York City. I'm the longest tenured morning show host in Hot 97 history. No one has lasted on mornings in hip-hop as long as me ever in the history of the genre. I do not get glamored by a free trip, you groupies. Stop it. If you're gonna go out there, at least go out there and be critical. At least go out there and say, I'm going out there, but I'm gonna ask the hard questions. Or I'm gonna say, I'm here, but I'm reluctant. No, you're just out there partying. Come on, fam. Do you even care about this? You know how many years, you know how many Sundays I've done this radio show and actually cared? You don't care. You're frauds. You're frauds. And then you 16-year-olds on Twitter who complain, y'all don't know shit. You don't know anything. You're SoundCloud fanboys. You don't know anything about the culture. You've never actually had anything happen to you in this culture. Do you know how many times I've been tested? You know how many issues I've had with artists? You know how many times... You see me walking right now down the streets of New York by myself? I have my entire career. Y'all aren't really in this. You're frauds. You don't have anything, any real attachment to it. So it doesn't matter to you. You sound like a salty hater. What would I be hating on? What would I be hating on? I was invited. You think I'm desperate for an interview with Kanye? I'm good. I got some good interviews planned. I'm good. So what would I be hating on? Everything's good. I've got a job at ESPN. I'm on Hot 97. I'm living my dream at WWE. I got all my things going. So what would I be upset about? So tell me. You said you can tell me what I'm hating on. Go ahead. I'm waiting. Tell me what I'm hating on. Looking like I'm mad. I am mad. See, here's another thing. Y'all think it's funny to make fun of people for caring. That's what you do, right? When you see someone showing emotion, you make fun of them. And you say, look at you, you're such a loser for caring. I care. I've been a DJ for 24 years. You like rap. I made it my life. Do you understand that? I now own a home and have a full life with multiple jobs, all because of hip-hop, all because of that. I care. Call me a dork, you 16-year-old loser. You've never done anything. You can't even wipe your ass. You've never had a job. I have more jobs this week than you've had in your life. I have multiple outlets that trust me to do a job. No one trusts you to do anything or make a decision. You don't do anything. So yes, it's frustrating. It's very frustrating when I then go online and see that other people who have a voice and a position to do something, didn't do anything. Well, guess what? You got glamored. You got glamored for a free trip. Don't feel bad. You're not the first person who got glamored for a free trip. But if you got out there and you didn't ask anything about what he said, all you said was, how's the album, fam? How's the album, bro? If that's all you did, congratulations, you played yourself. Goodbye.